Light bulbs. How do they work? Who invented them? How have they evolved? Oh, the questions of Modern Man. Questions we'll explore on today's episode of What's What. But first, don't forget to subscribe below. Some say an idea enlightens the mind as a bulb illuminates the room. But how does the human mind relate to light bulbs?
I can answer that.
Athena, of course you can.
I knew you always wondered where that analogy came from. Check it out. Your brain is made up of neurons, and those neurons produce electricity. And if you were to combine all the neurons and the electricity that it can produce in your brain, the sum would be enough to power, you guessed it, a light bulb.
That was surprisingly simple.
Like a lot of science.
Thanks, Athena. But we are here to talk about actual light bulbs. First and foremost, light bulbs produce light from a resistant wire that transmits electric current. Molecular agitation begins inside the material and the conductor generates heat. The material will emit electromagnetic radiations. And the hotter the radiation, the more light is produced. There you have it, the science of light in a light bulb. Now let us take it back to the old school. The first type of light bulb was the incandescent light. Inside every incandescent light, there is a resistant wire. When powered, the wire transmits electric current and emits heat. This heat is the manifestation of the Joule effect. Eventually, the temperature reaches a melting point, which makes the metal incandescent. As we mentioned earlier, its radiations become visible. Let there be light. Now, energy has to be channeled by a conductor somehow. That is where the filament comes in. The filament is that tiny little wire you see inside the light bulb, through which the Joule loss process occurs. The thinner the filament, the more resistance it processes, and the higher the losses will be. To improve the efficiency of the lamp, the filament usually consists of multiple coils formed in a helix or spiral shape. Basically, all that spun up wire will produce a greater glow. A good material for the filament is tungsten, which has the highest available melting point at 3400 degrees. Ouch! But what about the glass bulb? Why do we need it? When the filament heats, it can rapidly oxidize. That is why the filament is enclosed in, to protect it from oxidation and evaporation. Let's summarize the incandescent bulb. We have the Joule loss process, which heats the tungsten wire inside the bulb, or envelope. Of course, this all would not be possible without a power supply. But there is one big problem with incandescent bulbs. Unfortunately, the incandescent lamp is relatively inefficient. 5% of the power consumed is converted into visible light and 95% converts into heat. If you have ever worked in front of a camera, you know what I mean. That is why actors like Tom Cruise have stand-ins. I guess not many can relate. But maybe you heard your parents say, "Don't touch that," when you were reaching for a light. They warned you for a reason. Incandescent bulbs can reach a temperature of 200 Celsius degrees. So never cover up incandescent lights and be sure to keep space around them for sufficient ventilation. When purchasing light bulbs, check the cost of replacing bulbs compared to the cost of the electricity needed to power them. Typically, the lifetime of the incandescent bulb is only 1,000 hours. This is why incandescent lamps have been replaced by other lamp technologies such as LED. LED lights use a semiconductor called the diode to channel their electric currents. The diode emits photons through a process called electroluminescence. Sweet science. Yeah. But who came up with these bright ideas? many think Thomas Edison invented the first light bulb. However, historians have listed more than 20 inventors who came up with incandescent lamps before Edison. The problem? Their concepts were not suited for practical use. But Mr. Edison had a rigorous scientific approach and a giant industrial lab and about 10,000 workers. He had a lot. Edison's success was based on the three factors: effective material, high resistance making the supply power economically viable, and sufficient vacuum in the bulb to prevent oxidation. With all things considered, he was the first to create a fully functional light bulb in 1875. Well done, Thomas.
Did someone say fun facts?
I was about to. Go ahead.
Fun fact number one, Adolphe Chalette, an engineer with a patent for this carbon filament technology. He actually created the longest lasting light bulb, known as the centennial light bulb. Okay, well this actually is the centennial light bulb, but you guys know what I mean. Recorded as the longest lasting light bulb, it's been burning since 1901, and that can be explained by the increase of the resistance value. Now, this we already learned about from Frederic, but to tell you guys a little bit about it, it's gotten to about 0.3% of its original value. It used to burn at about a 60-watt light bulb. Now, it's only about 4 watts, which is about equivalent to a light bulb that you would find as a little nightlight in a children's bedroom. Talk about saving energy, kind of like this miniature solar panel behind me. Well, I'm all out of facts for today. We're gonna head back to Frederic in the studio to learn a little bit more. Bye, guys.
Thanks, Athena. If you all want to hear more about Edison or Nikola Tesla, we will talk about them in later episodes. In the meantime, don't forget, the basic science of light bulbs is interactions between electrons and ions on a given conductor. The Joule-Lhos process is the molecular agitation that creates heat. Incandescent lights are usually made up of a tungsten filament and glass bulb. They are rarely used in homes today, but still practical for construction, lighting, film sets, and more. LEDs use a semiconductor called the diode, which emits photons through a process called electroluminescence. Thomas Edison patented the first full functional light bulb, though there were many other versions invented before his. But most of all, remember that inventions really just come from a few curious minds who long to understand science. Do you have any bright ideas buried in your mind? Share below in our comment section. Until next time, au revoir!